21st April 2021 Morning Murali Om Shanti Bab Dada Madhuban Sweet children, you have now heard true things from the true father and come into the light. Your duty is to remove everyone from darkness and bring them into the light. Question: When you children give knowledge to anyone, what should you definitely remember? Answer: Constantly continue to make your mouth say Baba Baba, because by your doing this, any consciousness of mine will finish. The inheritance will also be remembered. When Baba is said, the notion of omnipresence is finished. If someone says that God is omnipresent, ask him, how can the Father be in everyone? So, people of today are in darkness. Om Shanti, what did the children say and to whom did they call out? O ocean of knowledge, O sun of knowledge, Baba, God is called Baba. God is the Father, and so all of you are children. The children say, we have now fallen into darkness. Take us into the light. By your saying Baba, it proves that you are calling out to the Father. When you say Baba, you experience love, because the inheritance is received from the Father. By simply saying Ishwar or Prabhu, there isn't that sweetness of the Father's inheritance. By saying Baba, you remember your inheritance. You call out, Baba, we have fallen into darkness. Come and ignite our lamps with knowledge. This is because the lights of souls have gone out. When a person dies, people keep a lamp light for 12 days. Someone stays up all night to make sure the lamp doesn't go out. The father explains, you people of Bharat were in the light, that is in the day, but you are now in the night. It is day for 12 hours and night for 12 hours. That is a limited aspect. This day and night are unlimited. It is called the day of Brahma, the golden and silver ages, and the night of Brahma, the copper and iron ages. There is darkness at night in which people continue to stumble around. They wander around in all directions searching for God, but they cannot attain God. They perform devotion in order to attain God. Devotion begins in the copper age, that is when the kingdom of Ravan begins. A story has also been made up about Dashera, means the burning of Ravan. They also make up stories with the imagination of their minds. For instance, they create films and plays, etc. The Srimad Bhagavad Gita is the truth. The Supreme Soul came and taught you children Raj Yoga and gave you the kingdom. Then they made up stories on the path of devotion. Vyas wrote the Gita, that is, he made up a story. You children are now listening to the true things from the Father. You should always continue to say, Baba, Baba. The Supreme Soul is our Baba. He is the creator of the new world, and we should therefore definitely receive the inheritance of heaven from him. While experiencing 84 births, we came into hell. The Father explains, children, you people of Bharat belong to the sun and moon dynasties when you were the masters of the world. There were no other religions. That was called heaven, the land of Krishna. Here, it is the land of devils. Bab Dada reminds you that it used to be the kingdom of Lakshmi and Narayan. Only the Father, not the Ganges, is the ocean of knowledge, the ocean of peace and the purifier. All the brides have one God who is the bridegroom. People don't know this. That is why they become confused when they are asked who the Father of all souls is. They reply, we don't know, O souls, but how can you not know your Father? They speak of God, the Father, but when you ask them what his name and form are, or whether they recognize him, They say that he is omnipresent. Can the father of children ever be omnipresent? People have become so senseless by following the devilish dictates of Ravan. Body consciousness is the number one vice. They don't have the faith that they are souls. They say, I am so and so. That refers to the body. In fact, they don't know who they really are. I am a judge. I am this. They continue to say, I, but that is wrong. I and mine are two distinct things. Souls are imperishable and bodies are perishable. A name is given to each body. Souls are not given names. The father says, my name is Shiv. People even celebrate the birthday of Shiva. How can the incorporeal one have a birthday? No one knows whom he enters. The name of all souls is Soul. The name of the Supreme Father is Shiv. And all the rest are saligrams. All souls are children, and Shiv is the father of all souls. He is the unlimited father. Everyone calls out to him, come and purify us. We are experiencing sorrow. Souls call out. All the children remember him when they are in sorrow. Whereas when those same children are in happiness, none of them remembers him. It is Ravan that has made you unhappy. The father explains that Ravan is your old enemy. This is the game of the drama that is created. Therefore, all are now in darkness. This is why they call out, O son of knowledge, come and take us into the light. When Bharat was the land of happiness, no one used to call out. There was nothing lacking there. Here, they continue to cry out, O bestower of peace. The father comes and explains that peace is your original religion and the garland around your neck. Souls are residents of the land of peace. You go from the land of peace to the land of happiness, where there is nothing but happiness. You don't have to cry out in distress. It is only when people are in sorrow that they cry out. Have mercy, Baba, remover of sorrow and bestower of happiness, come. Shri Baba, sweet Baba, come once again. He definitely comes. That is why people celebrate the birthday of Shiva. Sri Krishna is a prince of heaven. His birthday is also celebrated. But no one knows when Krishna came. Radhe and Krishna became Lakshmi and Narayan when they marry. No one knows this. Human beings continue to call out, Oh God the Father. Acha, ask them what his name and form are. And they say that he is beyond name and form. Oh, you say that he is God the Father. And then you say that he is beyond name and form. The sky is space, but it has the name sky. You say that you don't know the name or form of the Father. Acha, do you know yourself? Yes, I am a soul. Acha, what is the name and form of a soul? They say that each soul is the supreme soul. A soul cannot be beyond name and form. A soul is a point, like a star that resides in the center of the forehead. Such a tiny soul has a part of 84 births recorded in him. Thus matters have to be understood. This is why the furnace of 7 days is remembered. Ravan's kingdom began in the copper age, and it is ever since then that the vices have existed. You have continued to come down the ladder. Everyone is now eclipsed and has become ugly. That is why they call out, O son of knowledge, come. Come and take us into the light. It is said, when the Sadguru gives the ointment of knowledge, ignorance means darkness is dispelled. The intellect remembers the Father. It isn't said when the Guru gives the ointment. There are many Gurus, but none of them has knowledge. They are not remembered. Only the one Father is the ocean of knowledge, the purifier, and the bestower of salvation for all. Therefore, How could anyone else give knowledge? Sages say that there are many paths to meet God, that to study the scriptures, to hold sacrificial fires, to do tapasya, etc. All are paths to meet God. However, how could impure ones go to the pure world? The father says, I myself have to come. There is only one God. Brahma, Vishnu and Shankar are deities. They cannot be called God. Their father is Shiv. Since people are here, the father of people has to exist here. Does he not? The name that is written is Prajapita, Brahma Kumari's institution. Therefore, you are the children. There are many Brahma Kumars and Kumaris. The inheritance is received from Shiv, not Brahma. The inheritance is received from Dada, means the grandfather. He sits here and makes you worthy of going to heaven through Brahma. He adopts you children through Brahma. Children say, Baba, I belong to you. I claim my inheritance from you. The land of Vishnu is established through Brahma. Shri Baba teaches you Raj Yoga. The Gita is the elevated directions from God. There is only one God, the incorporeal one. The father explains, you children have taken 84 births. Souls have remained separated from the Supreme Soul for a long time. It is the people of Bharat who have been separated for a long time. It wasn't those of other religions. You are the ones who became separated first. You separated from the father and came here to play your parts. Baba says, oh souls, now remember me, your father. This is the pilgrimage of remembrance, the fire of yoga. The burden of sins on your head will be burnt away in this fire of yoga. Oh sweet children, from being in the golden age, you have come into the iron age. Now remember me. This is something for your intellects to do. Forget your bodies and all your bodily relations and constantly remember me alone. You are souls and those are your bodies. It is the soul that says, I. Ravan has made you impure. This play is predestined. There is the pure Bharat and the impure Bharat. When you became impure, you call out to the father that you want the kingdom of Ram. They say this, but they don't understand the meaning of it. Only the one father is the ocean of knowledge who gives you knowledge. Only the father comes and gives you the inheritance in a second. You now belong to the father in order to claim your inheritance of the sun and moon dynasties. You are immortal in the golden and silver ages. You won't say there that so and so has died. There is no untimely death in the golden age. You conquered death and there is no mention of sorrow. That is called the land of happiness. The father says, I give you the sovereignty of heaven. There are many facilities for comfort there. People on the path of devotion built such temples. Even at that time, they had so much wealth. Look how prosperous Bharat was. All the rest of the souls were in the incorporeal world. You children have come to know that the highest on high, Baba, is now established in heaven. The highest on high is Shri Baba. And then there are Brahma, Vishnu and Shankar, residents of the subtle region. Then there is this world. You children receive salvation through knowledge. It is remembered, knowledge, devotion and disinterest. There is disinterest in the old world because you are to receive the sovereignty of the golden age. The father says, children, now constantly remember me alone. By remembering me, you will come to me. Acha, to the sweetest, beloved, long lost and now found children, love, remembrance and good morning from the mother, the father, Baptada. The spiritual father says, Namaste to the spiritual children. The spiritual children says, Namaste and good morning to the spiritual father. Essence for the dharana. First point, the burden of sins on your head will be burnt away with the fire of yoga. Remove your body and all bodily relations from your intellect and remember the one father. Second point, instead of calling out or crying out in distress, remain stable in your original religion of peace. Peace is the garland around your neck. Don't use the words I and mine in body consciousness. Have the faith that you are a soul. Blessing, may you have a right to the highest status and with your elevated stage, make Maya bow down in front of you. Explanation. Great souls never bow down in front of anyone, but everyone bows down in front of them. In the same way, none of you, most elevated souls who have been selected by the Father, can let yourself bow down anywhere, in any situation, or to any of the various attractive forms of Maya. When you now remain stable in the stage that makes others bow down, you will then claim a right to the highest status. In the golden age, the subjects will bow down with respect in front of such souls, and in the copper age, devotees will bow down to your memorials. Slogan: let there be a good balance between karma and yoga, and you will then be called a karma yogi. Om Shanti.